Good evening, one and all presenter here. Today we are going to discuss about searching. Searching is nothing but searching is used to search any element from the list, right? Which is used to search any element from the list. Okay. Today we are going to discuss the sequential search algorithm. The another name for sequential search algorithm is linear search. Okay, linear search. Here this K is nothing but search key element. K is nothing but search key, that is the element to be searched. Okay, this is the pseudocode of searching. Initially the keyword algorithm, name of the algorithm is sequential search. Within bracket we need two inputs, one is array 0 to n minus 1, another one is K. K is search key element. Okay. The problem description of this algorithm is which is used to search any element from the given list. Input is two inputs. One is an array A of 0 to n minus 1 and a search key capital K, element to be found, to be searched. Output is which is used to return the index of the first element in the array which matches K, or it will return minus 1, no matches in the elements. Okay, initially I equivalent to 0, the conditions are while I is less than n and A of I is not equivalent to K, if the condition satisfied, increment the value of I equivalent to I plus 1. Next condition is if the value of I is less than n, return the value of I, else return minus 1. This is the pseudocode of sequential search. The next slide is, this is about iterations. Okay, this is about iterations. So the iterations are based on the pseudocode. Iterations are based on the pseudocode. Okay, so in iteration 1, initial value of I is 0, right? Initial value of I is 0. Now the conditions are, if I is less than n, two conditions. One is I is less than n. Another one is A of I is not equivalent to K, right? If both conditions are satisfied, increment the value of I by I plus 1. I equivalent to I plus 1. Next is, condition is if I is less than n, return the value I, right? That is I equivalent to I plus 1. Now the condition is 1 is less than 5, right? Is it clear, everyone? Any doubts? Any doubts in the iteration 1? Okay, if 1 is less than 5, return the value 1. Right, next iteration 2 was I equivalent to 1, right? In the next iteration, condition is 1 is less than 5 and A of 1 is not equivalent to 6, then I equivalent to I plus 1. If 2 is less than 5, now return the value 2, right? This is iteration number 2. Iteration number 3 is value of I will be incremented, right? I equivalent to 2, right? We return